Welcome to the channel Physics by IITians, where we learn physics, understand physics for cracking examinations and interviews. Our regular viewers knows that we have already discussed the topic normal Zeeman effect, the topic spin orbit interaction, the energy levels of different elements, associated physics. So let's start today's video, that is anomalous Zeeman effect. I shall discuss today anomalous Zeeman effect, origin of Landesi factor, Passchendaele effect, Stark effect. So we already know what is Zeeman effect. Still, I tell you, Zeeman in 1896, he observed that when a light source giving line spectrum is placed in an external magnetic field, the spectral lines which is emitted by the atoms of the source are split into a number of polarized components, and this field is less than several tens of one Tesla, and this splitting is proportional to the strength of the field, and this effect of the magnetic field on the atomic spectral lines is called Zeeman effect. There are two types of Zeeman effect. One is normal Zeeman effect, another is anomalous Zeeman effect. What is normal Zeeman effect? Normal Zeeman effect means you have any singlet state, you are getting one spectral lines for no magnetic field, and in place of when magnetic field extreme is present, this one line will be splitted into three components. One will be the main component, another will be with the same spacing, another two, okay, lies with the same spacing with respect to the main component. And in this case, the state is singlet state. Singlet state means where S is zero. I shall discuss about what is singlet, what is triplet, what is doublet states. So this is for the normal Zeeman effect. And what happens in case of anomalous Zeeman effect? The spectral lines is found to split into more than three components. Earlier it is found to split in three components, okay, with equal separations. But here you will get that, and it is usually observed. This is usually observed. This is special case. Anomalous Zeeman effect, that the usually observed Zeeman effect phenomena, and the spectral series lines are split up more than three components, and here the states are not singlet. That means S is not equals to zero. So 2S plus 1 is not equals to zero. So what happened if it is not 1? It can be 2S plus 1, it can be 2. 2S plus 1, it can be 3. So for 2S plus 1 equals to 3, that is a doublet state. For 2S plus 1 equals to 3, for 2s plus 1 equals to 2, that is doublet state. For 2s plus 1 equals to 3, that is triplet state. So here what we have discussed, that is its gist, that is any singlet state in case of normal Zeeman effect, it will split up into three components. And suppose this is a singlet state, and suppose we are taking a doublet state like sodium doublet, principal doublet, D1, D2 lines. What happened? We see that instead of three lines, we will observe more than three lines. Okay. Now we will understand what is the physics behind the anomalous Zeeman effect. Here I show you the mercury vapor lamp. The spectral lines of mercury vapor lamp at wavelength 546.1 nanometer showing anomalous Zeeman effect. This figure A shows you the magnetic the spectral lines without magnetic field. This figure B shows that transverse Zeeman effect, and this figure C shows the normal longitudinal Zeeman effect. What is transverse? What is longitudinal? The transverse is direction you are observing, which is perpendicular to the external magnetic field, and longitudinal is direction you are observing is parallel to the external magnetic field. Okay, so look here, without magnetic field you are seeing only one line. In case of the presence of magnetic field here, due to it's depending on the direction of the magnetic field and your observation, it will split up into different components. For the transverse direction, your field lines will be splitted like this way. For the longitudinal direction, your field lines will be splitted like this way. Now this is another, suppose you are taking doublet, you can also take triplet. For triplet also it is present, because here look, when field is off, you are seeing only one spectral line. When field is on, you are seeing that this one spectral line is splitted into several different components, and different spectral lines we can observe whenever the field is on. And it is happening doublet, it is happening for triplet, okay? So what we have now understand, we will understand that what will be singlet state, what will be doublet state, what is triplet state. Okay, singlet, suppose there is the one is spin up and another is spin down. The two electrons, one having spin up, another having spin down. So there is no unpaired electron. So no unpaired electrons means half plus half, that is overall spin, and that should be zero. Okay. This is the singlet state because this 2s plus 1 will give us 1. Now suppose there is one unpaired electron. So this is up spin, down spin, it is 0 overall. But here you have an unpaired electron. So the overall spin is 2, resultant spin, that is half, not 2. So half. So 2s plus 1 will be 2. And since 2s plus 1 is the multiplicity is the 2, it is called doublet. Now suppose you have two states where you have two electrons, both have spin up. So this half plus half overall s you will get as 1, which will become 2s plus 1 you get as 3. So 2s plus 1 is 3, that is multiplicity is 3, and it is called triplet state. So the normal Zeeman effect is for singlet one, and anomalous Zeeman effect is valid for doublet triplet state. Here you don't have to consider spin, but here you have to consider the spin effect of the electron also. Okay, that is the main difference between the normal and anomalous Zeeman effect. Okay, and also the magnetic field in case of anomalous Zeeman effect should be lower or weaker. Why is it so? We will discuss it. Now we have to understand the what is the origin of anomalous Zeeman effect. The origin of anomalous Zeeman effect is spin orbit interaction. Why? Because J is equals to L plus S, that is the total angular momentum is the vector addition of orbital angular momentum and spin angular momentum. So that resultant J will precess about the direction of an applied B field. So there are 2J plus 1 possible orientations of the J in the field directions. So that is J cos phi equals to MJ into H cross. So our MJ can take value from plus J to minus J. Now since this atomic energy levels are depending on this value or orientations of J, the atomic energy levels will also split up into 2J plus 1 closely lying components. So the splitting of the splitting of the adjacent levels depends on the value of J. Okay, so mu J, what will be the value of mu J? That is the resultant spin angular moment due to the addition of the vector addition of the mu L, that is magnetic moment due to the orbital angular motion momentum, and magnetic moment due to the spin angular motion. Okay, so that will become, so mu L is already, we know that mu L equals to E H cross by 2 ICME into root over L into L plus 1, and mu S equals to 2 into E by 2 ICME into PS, that is E by 2 ICME into 2 into root over S into S plus 1. So these are the values for mu L and mu S. So mu J equals to root over J into J plus 1 into G into mu B. Okay, so mu B is the Bohr magneton and G is the Landesi factor or splitting factor. The value of G is 1 plus J into J plus 1 plus S into S plus 1 minus L into L plus 1 divided by 2J into J plus 1. Thus the splitting of the atomic energy levels in a magnetic field of flux density B is, suppose here is in an external magnetic field, or there is a magnetic field which is experiencing the electron, it will have an energy mu epsilon B will be mu J into B into cos JB. Because whenever there is an magnetic field and it is J which is precessing about the magnetic field, there will be an angle, that is the angle between J and B, that is denoted as cos JB. And so since we know that epsilon B, that is the energy due to the magnetic field, is minus mu J dot B, so its dot product is the cos JB angle. And since it is electron, mu J and PJ are in difference in direction, reverse direction, so we get mu J B cos JB. So now put the value of mu J, that is root over J into J plus 1 into G into mu B in this formula, and you will get that epsilon B equals to mu B into B into G into mj, where J is different for different L, S, J values. Here because G is depending also on J, also on S, also on L. So due to the difference in L, S or J values, we can get different G levels or different G values. Now, what will be the allowed transition? The allowed transition will be delta mg equals to 0 plus minus 1. Now, we understand the magnetic splitting for the sodium doublet series, that is sodium D lines. The D lines occur between P half state to S half state, and this is 2P half state to 2S half state. This is doublet, so it is denoted as 2, and this is D1 line, and 2P 3 by 2 state to 2S half. This is for D2 line. And the D1 line will split into 4 components, where D2 line will split into 6 components in the presence of magnetic field. How is it so? Let us find out the G value, MJ value and GMJ value for the different levels for the sodium line, D line. So this 2S half value, J will be half. So MJ is plus half or minus half, and G is 2. G into MJ is plus minus 1. G, how it was calculated? It is calculated by this formula. G equals to, you have to remember this formula. You can directly ask to find out the G values, and you will be given the spectral term. Like, you are given this term 2S half, and you have to find out the G value. So you put the G formula and you get as 2. And G into MJ will become plus minus 1. So for 3, 2p half, this is 3 is the principal number, this 2 is the 2s plus 1, and this half is J value, and this p denotes you the L term. In the earlier lecture, I have denoted all the things. Please, if you have any problem regarding the spectral term notation, please watch that video, I request you. So G will be for this spectral value. This term value is 2 by 3. G into MJ will be plus minus 1 by 3. Or for 2P 3 by 2, G MJ values are plus minus 3 by 2 plus minus half. So G value 4 by 3. So G into MJ will be plus minus 2 plus minus 2 by 3. So look here, the different G values, different MJ values will give you different energy levels. So it is the beautiful phenomena that whenever this interacting G MJ is different, you are getting different values for same level, for same term value, you are getting different energy levels. So how beautiful it is, right? You have to understand this. So how to draw this diagram? That suppose this is our 2s half, so it will be split into two levels, one with plus half, another with minus half. And for 2p half, it will also be split into two levels, one with plus half, another is minus half. And these are the transitions from minus half to plus half, from plus half to plus half, minus half to plus half to plus half. That is delta mj equals to 0 and plus minus 1, that are our allowed transitions. So, or minus half to minus half, plus half to minus half. So, these are the allowed transitions. So, we are getting 4 spectral lines, sigma, pi, pi, sigma. So, this is for D1 line. We will discuss about what is pi line and what is sigma line. Let us first find out the diagram appropriately. So this is, suppose this is our 2s half state. So it will be splitted into two components. One is plus half, one will be minus half. And for 2p 3 by 2, it will be splitted into four components, because mj is plus 3 by 2 to minus 3 by 2. So plus 3 by 2, plus half, minus half, minus 3 by 2. And the m into g values will be also different. So the apply our transition rule, that is allowed transition rule, and you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 components. Now we read the results. So for MJ equals to 0, the lines are polarized with the electric vector parallel to the applied magnetic field, and it is called as pi component when observed perpendicular to the field direction. And now for delta MJ equals to plus minus 1, they are polarized with the electric vector perpendicular to the magnetic field, that is sigma component. So for MJ equals to delta MJ 0, we are getting pi component, and for delta MJ equals to plus minus 1, we are getting sigma component. And it will depending upon the polarization of the light or lines, okay? And you are observing it perpendicular to the field direction, that is transverse Zeeman effect. Now we shall understand what is this G factor? Why is it coming here? Okay, we will physically understand the origin of G factor. The derivation is easy. The origin of G factor is, suppose this is a 3D diagram. The L is also precessing, J is also precessing, the S is also precessing, and L and S are coupling to give you J value. Okay, now this is the 2D diagram, which I request you to observe thoroughly, that this is along X and this is L. Okay, so L and S will give you J value, the resultant angular momentum. Now the resultant angular momentum has a component, that is mu, that is the resultant angular spin moment, or resultant spin angular moment, that is mu. But look here, this L, the orbital angular momentum, has a spin magnetic moment of mu L, and the spin angular momentum S has a spin magnetic moment as mu S. But look, this mu L and L, this L mu L by L, the length is of 1, because G factor is 1 here. That is, the length of L is equal to the length of mu L. But here, the S and mu S, they are not equal. Rather, they are related with the factor G equals to 2. So, S and mu S having different magnitude, and mu S is double than S. Now, whenever this mu S and mu L will couple, they will give a resultant magnetic moment, okay? And that is mu, and this J has resultant magnetic moment as mu J. So, that was my mistake, that I told you that J has the resultant magnetic moment mu. That is not true. J has the opposite magnetic moment as, J has the resulting magnetic moment as mu J, and from mu S and mu L, you have a resulting magnetic moment as mu, and mu and mu J are not same due to the difference in the length of mu L and mu S. And this is the origin of G factor. Okay, so what is written, let me tell you, that we know the vectors L and S precess about the direction of the magnetic field. Okay, about the magnetic field, and the magnetic moments mu L and mu S due to the orbital and spin motion are aligned anti-parallel to the vector L and S respectively. Now mu, that is the resultant magnetic moment, should be mu L plus mu S, and this has a different direction that from the J. So J has a result associated magnetic moment as mu J, and mu L and mu S will couple each other and give a resultant magnetic moment as mu, and they don't have the same direction. So why is it so? Because this is the spin motion is twice that of the orbital motion. So the vector mu S should be drawn its length twice that of the S, having direction opposite to S, and this is what has been done in this figure. This means the resultant magnetic moment vector mu will have a different direction, that is the resultant from the resultant angular momentum J. And when you find out mu J, that is the resultant angular momentum from the J, angular moment associated with the J, that is mu J is mu L cos LJ plus mu S cos SJ. Okay? And you find it out after certain calculations, you find this G factor arising due to the difference in L, mu L and mu S value, and you find it out as calculated as mu L, you know the values mu L, mu S. Whenever you find out, try to find out this mu S value, mu J value, so you will find is there is coming certain G factor, I mean this factor, and this factor is known as G factor. Okay, so this is also called Landesi factor or splitting factor. Now what are the applications of Zeeman effect? The Zeeman effect, the George Allais was first noticed the Zeeman effect in the solar spectra, and he understand that there is the existence of so strong magnetic fields in sunspots. So various astronomical observations can be done on the Zeeman effect, and we can as the splitting is proportional to B, we can find out the magnetic field associated with that spectral lines. Laser cooling also, Zeeman effect is as a very huge applications in लेजर कूलिंग ऑल्सो एज सच एज मैग्नेटो ऑप्टिक ट्रैप जिमैन श्लोअर. ओके नाउ व्हेन एवर द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड बिकम वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग वॉट विल हैपन द व्हेन एज द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड बिकम स्ट्रॉन्ग द स्प्लिटिंग ऑफ द स्पेक्ट्रल लाइन्स बिकम सिमिलर टू द नॉर्मल जिमैन स्प्लिटिंग एंड दिस इज नोन एज पैशन बैक इफेक्ट. एंड वाई इज इट सो बिकॉज इन अ स्ट्रॉन्ग मैग्नेटिक फील्ड द कपलिंग बिटवीन एल एंड ए इज टू फॉर्म जे इज ब्रोकन सो एल एंड एस विल इंडिपेंडेंटली प्रीसेस अबाउट द फील्ड डायरेक्शन एंड एल विल हैव अ पॉसिबल कॉम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ 2L प्लस 1 ओरिएंटेशंस एंड एस हैव 2S प्लस 1 डिफरेंट ओरिएंटेशंस एंड एप्सिलॉन बी दैट इज एनर्जी लेवल विल बी म्यू बी बी टू ML प्लस 2ms. सो एंड द रूल फॉर द ट्रांजिशन आर अलाउड रूल आर डेल्टा ML इक्वल्स टू 0 प्लस माइनस 1 डेल्टा ms इक्वल्स टू 0. Also, which is not included here, that is the residual interaction between L and S makes the splitting more complicated. And for that, the energy level, that is delta E equals to lambda NL ML into MS. So, L equals to 0, this delta E will be 0. If L is not 0, then this is delta E is not 0. And this delta E NL or lambda E n l, it depends on the energy value of E n. Okay, so the here, look here, whenever the weak magnetic field L and S are coupling and they are giving us resulting J, and due to the difference in mu J and resultant mu, we get a G factor, and due to this pin orbit interaction, we get anomalous Zeeman effect. Now for the strong electrical field, both L and S will individually or independently precess about J, and they don't affect each other and they don't couple with each other. So we will get splitting lines like normal Zeeman effect. What is Stark effect? In 1913, an effect similar to the Zeeman effect, in which a spectral line is split into several components by the action of an electric field, and this was discovered by J. Stark, and this is known as Stark effect. So friends, today what we have discussed about the spin orbit interaction that is happening to give us anomalous Zeeman effect, and where you get find out the magnetic field, how you get the spin orbit interaction. I repeatedly request you to watch the earlier videos so that you can understand. If you find my videos helpful, you can help me by clicking a link given in the description box. Don't forget to like the channel, subscribe the channel, and share the videos if you find it helpful. Thank you.